RaggyBeats.net.
Switching to Shopify helps you sell smarter at every stage of your business. Take full control of your brand with your own custom online store.
Wow, looks amazing.
Find more customers with our easy-to-use marketing tools.
Piece of cake.
And let the best converting checkout on the...
Welcome to L.O.T.E. Wrestling with your boy Ranger. Welcome in Facebook, welcome in YouTube. What's really good? Thank you for the like, I appreciate that on YouTube. That's what's up. I wasn't gonna stream, but I was watching the first hour of WWE Legends, Roman Reigns, Tribal Chief. I was like, you know what? I gotta go online. I gotta stream. I'm tired, but I'm gonna stream a little bit. I'm gonna do a little gaming, AI versus AI. I got it kind of set up, but because the Tribal Chief was on TV, I think I got an extra hour in me. Maybe more. We'll see. I stay being on there for mad long. Just be talking to myself, chilling, hanging out. But I'm hyped to see WWE Legends with Roman Reigns, though. Like, that's kind of quick to me. That's what's up. That's milestones right there. I like we could see a lot of behind the scenes of a lot of things they're doing, what they did before. Like, that's pretty cool. But I kind of already knew his story. Like, I already followed him for, like, mad long. So, I kind of know who Roman Reigns is, and I kind of understand why he is where he is, why he deserves what he got. I'm just saying. If you ain't follow him, if you in the world did not follow Roman Reigns' career, or even try to backtrack it or look up a little history on it and all that, you probably wouldn't understand why he is where he is today. But yes, happy Sundays, happy Easter to all. I went to work. It wasn't happy Easter till I got out. And then I had a lot of things to do. I was in and out a lot. So now I'm able to, like, relax a little bit. Woosa as usual. Got my Pepsi, got my ice, got my herbs, got my bogeys. Tribal Chief on TV. I'm good to go.
Brooklyn.
That's when everybody went silent. When he said he lived with leukemia for 11 years, yeah. Everybody shut their mouths like, damn. The only time people said thank you when he said he had leukemia. People's just grimy, bro. All them people that was booing him when he walked in that arena, when he won that, came in on that Monday when he won the championship, it felt like shit. Had to add to some of the matches, you know what I mean? Made it a little interesting. Get the Xbox in there. Alright, let's see if it would have come out.
Get your blunt, get your pets, get your snacks ready.
WWE Universe just exploded!
The following contest is a Falls Count Anywhere match. Making his way to the ring from the wasteland. Weighing in at 305 pounds, Bear Bricks!
Big time match on tap. When the competition level is this high, you can bet it will be memorable.
Bear Bricks.
The look of focus and determination on his face. He wants to show the world that he can compete on this high level.
I would like to thank everybody that likes, views, takes a peek. Even if for 2 seconds, I appreciate you. Heard. Appreciate you hanging out with me, checking out the stream, hearing what I'm talking about. If there's anything to talk about, honestly, the only thing, good thing to really talk about in wrestling right now is Tribal Chief, Rock, WrestleMania, Cody Rhodes, Drew McIntyre. I'm just saying. I don't know what Tony Khan says to Eric Bischoff, but bro, wrong move, bro. That's a bad decision, Tony Khan. I'm just saying, Eric Bischoff, Vince Russo, like, they've been in the business, they've been in the ins and the outs, like, they have their success, they have their fails, like, they know what it is, bro. They know what they can read what you're doing, bro. But don't go at Eric, bro.
Falls count anywhere. We've seen this type of match devolve pretty quickly. That's a beauty, Cole. I don't think anyone cares about a win here. This is about punishment. It's about making a statement to the whole locker room that you're not someone to trifle with. Neckbreaker! middle rope. Able to parry that one.
I'm sorry, but I'm watching the whole Legend of Wrestling. It makes me laugh, bro. You can't tell me that this is like the best story.
Wherever your opponent takes the fight, you must be ready to follow. So expect the unexpected and have a plan in your back pocket for any situation. A back suplex right onto the apron. After that attack on the apron, there is no way we're seeing them leave this arena without medical assistance. Caught in a bad position here. Oh, watch this, fellas.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like Paul Heyman was like the best manager ever since ECW. Like, he has like a real love for the business. You know what I mean? Like, he always has some input and is always intellectually smart. Like, I don't know. If I was to be a wrestler, I would want Paul Heyman. I would be a Paul Heyman. I'm just saying.
To expect victory yet. Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Looks like he James was a good actor too, though. Like, he got a little bit of skill. I think it's awesome that I'm watching this show right now, and everybody like has respect for him. I don't care what they post now. I don't care what they post after me. Everybody had respect for him because he worked for it.
I don't know how someone kicks out of that. I don't know how
like he found himself. Everything in the bloodline story, everything with the bloodline and all that stuff was natural for him and became natural for everybody.
He has to be at his limit now. He needs to get himself some room to regroup fast. Wow, what an arm drag. A thunder, penalty kick, shoulders down. Quick count out after one. Somehow still has the energy for a quick kick out. I don't like the look in his eye here, folks. Up high, cross body from the top. He's getting fired up now, really feeding off this crowd. Hooked up, DDT. And he's just flaunting his skills now. Stringing together some big moves here. Oh. Taking this to the floor.
If Roman drops the title at WrestleMania 40 and he takes time off after that, I'll accept that because that, in a way, completes Roman's story. If I'm correct, according to him. Everything at this WrestleMania is coming back to when he first got that championship, when The Rock came out at the end and... He got booed. He's got to keep saying that. Because he got booed. That.
No one was willing to give even a single inch
he had to redevelop. He repackaged himself. You know what I'm saying?
Here you see the one who prevailed.
It comes back to Philadelphia. This is where everybody booed him. And he... That's the worst moment of his career. Legitimately. His worst moment that he won and everybody still booed him. This is why y'all dumb motherfuckers out here in the world acknowledge the tribal chief, because you booed him when you shouldn't have booed him. But now you respect him, whether you like him or not. Roman said he's not the good guy, he's not the bad guy, he's just the guy.
becomes one of my favorites.
I saw a report saying that WWE copied AEW because of Jade Cargill debuting and saying a couple words, and Mercedes Moné debuted like a week or two ago and said a couple words. No, I don't think so.
The odds are they will always be stacked against them.
They were probably just waiting for it to get closer to WrestleMania to actually sign her contract. That's why she said she's never going to wrestle. Like, it's kind of obvious she was going to come and do something for WrestleMania.
He has a big match ahead of him. Going to need a career.
And I did expect her to say something at a signing, just like Mercedes. Like, both of them, I expected to say something. So, I think that's dumb. At the end of the day, AEW needs to copy more WWE. Just saying.
Yeah, now we're talking.
Like, who needs to copy another organization because of a debut and a promo? Don't they all do that? I'm just saying.
Thinks a little bit too much of themselves, but the tape doesn't lie. This is a serious contender for any title. They need to loosen up, have a little fun, heck, maybe even lose a match once in a while.
What? That is horrible advice.
Competitor who does not know the meaning of the word quit. He is ready for battle.
You know you're doing big things when Stone Cold Steve Austin tells you your word.
You beat your opponent once you put him through a table. We know the WWE Universe is primed and ready for this one.
Absolutely, Michael. We constantly hear the chance of, we want tables. And tonight, here they are.
It's weird. I swear I constantly hear chants of fire, Saxton. And I haven't heard anybody do anything about that yet.
I never heard those chants, Corey.
Goes under the ropes to get back inside.
The WWE Universe is pouring more fuel on his fire right now.
Ow, that's a little disrespectful.
Insulting, but this is just gonna hurt.
Oh, boom, drop kick. He turns it around.
From behind.
Oh, wow.
Frankensteiner.
Nice.
Yo. Roman Reigns just got better and better and better, bro. I'm just saying.
Anything stopping.
And this one might be headed ringside.
That table has only one destiny, and it involves being broken in half.
Slingshot. Oh, just completely off target there.
An absolutely foolhardy decision made there.
That could be very costly. Don't know if the risk is worth it.
Byron, what could be the deciding factor in a table's
this match setting. It is all about being able to survive a true.
I swear, Roman Reigns spears and wrestling in the same way he did in football. It's funny.
Losing the match. Some of the biggest upsets in WWE history have occurred in tables matches. I think it might happen again here tonight. Get back here. Leg lariat. He's looking a little off balance.
See how much bread Roman Reigns bought in WWE, bro? That's crazy. That's what AEW is looking for, you know? A needle mover. That's what AEW is looking for. You ain't doing it without compelling storylines, bro. Tony Khan, if you, that's what you trying to do. He needs a real hard, real compelling story.
Going through the table like that adds salt to the wound of losing. It's never fun to lose, but the added pain of going through a table is insult to injury. Never a doubt, barely a moment's suspense. This one was about as lopsided as they come.
Sorry. Oh, whoa. Dang.
Some highly motivated performers in this match, looking to steal the show and capture the attention of the entire WWE Universe.
Mm.
that the crowd rallies behind someone so disingenuous, always making jokes on social media about the rest of the locker room.
Well, Corey, so far, all the people who were called out deserve that hostility.
Yo, Vince Russo is funny, bro. He makes me laugh. I like watching Vince Russo podcasts too. Him and Eric Bischoff, I like them both. And Conrad, 83 Weeks. I like that show too. I like all three of them. I listen to a little bit of Jim Cornette. I listen to them. Everybody has a different opinion. Everybody has a different thought. Everybody has a different view. And I respect all because they've all been in the business in one way or another. Therefore, Vince Russo makes me laugh. Eric Bischoff makes me laugh. But Eric Bischoff makes me think more than laugh. Like, I be like, damn, Eric. For real, though. But Vince Russo be just making me laugh, right? He just kind of keeps it real. I don't know, right? Vince Russo keeps it freaking real. I don't know who you are, what you say. Vince Russo makes me laugh, bro. And he honestly has many, many points. Because many points he says, I even said before I even watched his show. And when I heard him say it, I was like, damn, bro. That's what I've been saying. And I'm like, yo, he's been saying the same shit I've been saying. I've been saying Cody Rhodes is a freaking heel. He's awkward. He's an awkward character. And he's just weird. I don't connect with him, and then when I watched Vince Russo, and I finally, like, found his podcast, and that's why I started talking more about wrestling, because I see they talk about it, too. I was like, yo, he's saying the same shit, because he was like, Cody Rhodes is a heel. Like, I said he was a politician. He said he's a politician. Roman wrestler. Roman wrestler. Cody Rhodes is a politician. I mean, and that's just how his character looks. And that's why it just doesn't seem like championship material to me. I let you beat Gunther. I let you win that one. But they gotta groom you the way they groom Roman Reigns. I'm sorry, but that's what they have to do. They have to find a way to make you like that. I don't know how, but... And that's something that Roman Reigns had to do. He figured that out when he was like, yo, I gotta change what I'm doing. Like, he had to make it right. So, your character has to be right. But believable, too. Like, I like Big Dog. Just because, like, it's Roman. I just like, well, you know, Tribal Chief is better, of course, because it's just more natural. They have a natural feel to him. Like, he fits the character. The character fits him. Like, you have to be the character, and the character has to be you. You have to be yourself. The character's weird. I don't know. I mean, you're a good guy, but it's like Clark Kent, bro.
Clark Kent.
That's all I gotta say.
But yeah, he said,
is Rhea Ripley a heel or a face? Because she did the Sting face.
You know, so, you know, that's like having fun and good stuff. And that's funny just to read the headline. I mean, I feel like in a house show, she's like a face in a way. Like, she just wants to entertain a little bit more to the crowd.
But when the show's on and TV's on, she's a little bit more heelish. And he thinks Tony Khan would book The Undertaker versus Sting. I'm dead. But I can see Tony Khan trying to do that. Give a mad bread too.
Here is your winner, Lady
That's the good thing about one of those steel cage matches. They're stupid to know how to climb out. They can pin
or submit. That's cool.
This sort of win shakes up the women's division.
Part will always make me laugh when he said, "I don't give a damn what the Tribal Chief said, Jey Uso," and then he picks his head up, Roman.
Yeah, that shit always has me dying.
I think that same night I had to whip my head back, like, "Oh shit." Yo, is anybody watching this with me, bro?
Yeah, that's awesome, bro.
Oh, yeah, I am pumped for this guy.
Friendly goes. I am.
The tension building for this match is so thick you can cut it with a knife. A lot of drama involved with this one.
Yeah, the temperature is the plumbing. That heat. It chill.
Where'd you net? Thank you.
the focus and drive in his eyes, ready to prove he's the best this division has to offer.
Becky Lynch is really mad that Rhea Ripley did the stink face though, because she showed a little cheeks. It's not that bad.
Here we go, guys.
And his opponent. This is something she wanted to do. Why are you so mad? I'm just saying. It's all right. What are they doing? Is all right. Timing.
Hey, where's the horse? What are you talking about?
Yeah, what horse?
The high horse this superstar always seems to be on. Did Jerry Lawler write that line for you?
Try to cheat. WWE rivals. I guess I'll be watching that again.
A competitor with his share of detractors, but he wants to prove them all wrong here tonight. Submission match, I made sure I did my homework before the match even began.
What kind of homework are you talking about?
I made a list of every single nick and cut and injury that my opponent ever suffered in their career. Then, when I was in the... Going downstairs! Ow!
Yeah, talk about a desperate attempt to stay in this thing.
You take the high road, Saxton, I'll take the low road. I guarantee I'll reach the destination before you do.
That was a very questionable attack. I think it goes beyond any gray area.
Look at the angle. It's nasty.
Attacking the back in that way, there's definitely a plan in place here. Shattering spine buster.
Shawn Michaels is so old, as the kids say, his balls.
Can you guys believe the power? Running elbow drop on target. This match grinded him down a little. Oh, using the knee as a weapon.
He's staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
Suicide tornado DDT. A roll of the dice and it pays off in full. Just a straight deadlift of power into a
dominator.
No other way to say it, guys. That looked like it hurt a lot.
Strategy is, of course, very important in a match like this. Corey, your thoughts?
We talk a lot about how the key to submission matches are to focus on a specific part of the body and just go to work. But I think you need to think bigger. Any and all weaknesses need to be targeted. Even noticing a paper cut and zeroing in on it can mean the world in a match like this.
Back into the ring.
Big risk here. He may be counted out.
He might be oblivious to the count, guys.
Strikes with the back elbow.
Taking a moment to get pumped off of this crowd's incredible energy.
stop for the spine.
You know what's coming next.
Accolade, the accolade.
It's over.
He's got it locked in. It's locked in.
Now, an emphatic victory.
Here is your winner.
Jimmy's crying.
I'm done.
Wow, just wow. A tremendous win in this match. Yep, that's what we call a good day at the office.
Facts. Facts.
Jim Ross said awesome
wrestling. Right now is unlike anything I've ever felt in quite some time. This match is gonna be good.
Triple H and The Rock rivals.
Doesn't matter if the title's on the line here tonight. This woman lives to compete under any circumstance.
I seen this match title.
And her opponents, first from Dublin, Ireland, May.
This
competitor is just way, way too aggressive. They need to do some breathing exercises or something. Unlock the inner peace.
I'm a little surprised to hear that from you, Corey. You endorse anyone who brings a little animosity to the ring.
Well, maybe sometimes I do, but this is too much. They should dial it back. Do some yoga.
She is physically and mentally prepared for the task at hand in tonight's match. Someone I can give my full support to. Someone who has the guts to stand up for what's right.
What are they, a knight in shining armor? Give me a break.
Such an incredible journey for this woman, but she knows a win tonight will take her even further.
Superstars in the ring, and here we go with our triple threat match.
Three determined superstars, I'd say. They all believe this is their match to win.
Well, I get the math, and they've each got a clean 33.3% chance of victory.
Up for the electric chair, down for the drop.
Set up in the corner of the ring.
Bulldog! Ooh, what a forearm club.
To the outside.
Gonna risk it all right here.
Thinking about it. Gonna do it.
Suicide dive! Just a devil may care attitude on full display.
Going for broke and it pays off.
Into the ankle breaker.
About to be the proverbial one-legged man in the you-know-what kicking contest.
Throws her back in from ringside. She's getting herself in the zone, but she shouldn't hesitate much longer.
Kendo stick to the skull.
You know, a Falls Count Anywhere match is a really exciting opportunity. It really allows you to get creative and take the action to somewhere you have the advantage.
That's certainly one way of looking at what many would characterize as an incredibly dangerous match type.
And the exclamation point.
Takedown, and now punches right.
Brutality. Practically never-ending blows coming at full force here. I don't know what you're thinking when you throw an opponent out of the ring like that.
Dangerous Hurricane Rana. She needs to stop saying she's going to bring it and actually deliver on the promise.
Grabbing a kendo stick, any connection with flesh will definitely leave a welt.
Slam.
counter. Comes back into the ring. German suplex. Things taking a turn for her now. And a suplex. Oh. Sidewalk slam. Trapping the wrist. Oh, what a knee. Guess that's one way to incite your opponent. I don't know if they're going to have any taste buds left after that. Splash to follow. Oh! Boom! Impact.
Damn, she caught her.
Oh my goodness. Ah, oh, what a smash. That is just insulting. All right, she's back in, ready to go.
That's disrespectful.
But I guarantee they're going to take great umbrage with that offense. Side. It wasn't the. Here it comes. Stay away from the worm. They think she breaks the hold. She bails in a hurry. Letting her opponent know she is ready for anything.
Uh-oh. I don't know what she has planned with that kendo stick.
Just one step ahead. And that definitely made solid impact. She thinks she has it. Gets the shoulder up in one.
Getting that shoulder up seemed to be pretty easy.
Now looking for something to waylay her opponent with.
Those are folding chairs, but they can also fold you in half.
Oh, knee drop.
Scoreboy pinning combination.
Oh, maybe not.
And she is rapidly dictating the pace.
Yeah, she just continues to unload on her opponent. Suplexes, slams, and bombs are all painful, but being slapped like that is humiliating.
You would know, Saxton. There's pressing. That is damage. You can't get caught in a hailstorm like that if you want to win. Ooh, look at her answering back. Smash him in the face. Up and down. Face buster.
Man.
Into the pin attempt. Gets the shoulder up.
She is still very much in this.
Looking for the suplex all the way up. Look at this power. Oh, no. And returning to the ring.
Dragon screw targeting the ankle.
This match is wearing her down. I'm just surprised that this triple threat match is still going on, Cole. I bet Saxton this would have been over by now.
Oh!
Knee right to the face. She's found an opening. Suplex.
Take. Uh-oh. And she gets herself out of a precarious position.
Boom! Scorpion death drop.
Oh, man, kick to the face. We might just be seconds away from the end.
Two count. No, she kicks out. She kicks out.
You gotta be kidding me.
Surviving that maneuver is absolutely amazing. And now it's reload time. Time to find another moment to pull off that one more time. Into the ankle breaker.
And she's using this moment to summon all of her strength. Ooh.
It's crazy how Roman Reigns went through the same exact thing as
that. That was just insulting.
DDT to follow. Right after the neck.
The Rock got booed out of the building. He said something has to change. Roman Reigns got booed out of the building. He said something has to change.
That she is tapping into another level here, and it could pay off.
She goes back inside the ropes. Double knee to the chin. Lock it in, the Dragon Sleeper.
Think about all the pain she's in right now. Showing the world just how much fight she's got left.
pins broken up. And she's been taking an enormous amount of scratching and clawing. This could be it. And she thwarts the pin attempt and won. She is still in this fight.
Steady legs in the corner, needs to recover.
Ooh. Hooked up. Oh, look at the power. Side slam. Drop kick. Jawbreaker interrupts the attack. Oh, jaw shattering.
She's pumping herself up, reaching out for that burst of energy.
Coming back in. Shoulders down. Running interference.
It's still brawling.
The best shot was thrown, but it couldn't put this match away. What a match. What a match. Face first.
Scoreboard pinning combination.
Oh, maybe not.
For the win. Two. Oh, perfect kick. Go behind, applied, taken down, and then a nasty heel kick right to the face. Oh, man, what a boot. One more time, throwing the heavy artillery.
From behind, back suplex.
Now that'll do some serious damage.
She's getting back to her feet, but is there fight left?
Ooh, what a chop! Natural selection!
This could be the chance she was looking for!
Cover. And she's still in the game.
Not about to go quietly into the night.
That took some serious endurance, I'll give you that. And that result leaves everyone shocked. But will the shoulder come up if that move hits one more time?
These superstars have toiled away endlessly, and this crowd is on their feet in full appreciation.
An incredible sight to see. Oh, look at just... Oh, look at this claw on the face. And now she's getting back into the ring.
Three.
Oh, what a kick.
might be just moments away from tapping out.
Look at this. She releases the hold.
That's a little surprising, no?
What's she got here? Judo throw, oh, cutter. Moves outside. What's the plan here? Slipway.
Nicely done.
Boom. Oh, sit out, axe driver.
She just created a prime opportunity.
Second row, bulldog.
More attacks up there could leave her severely impaired.
She has her target, weighed and measured. And back into the ring she goes. Hoisted up across the shoulders into a sit-out axe driver.
Amazingly executed once more.
Yo, D-Lo.
Oh, nailed the midsection. Takes their breath out. Effective counts.
She's getting fired.
Oh, the back of the face.
Each one keeps getting more devastating.
And the count's broken, keeping the match alive.
It's not over yet.
Kick right to the face. Oh, no, trapping the arm. Vicious stomp to the hand.
To the outside.
The wheels are turning.
Suicide dive. That's finding any which way to topple the competition.
Hurling your own body like that is insane.
Textbook neck breaker. Boom. This could do it. Broke it up. And the match continues. Now her DDT.
Telling her opponent that she has even more left in her tank.
So take things into the ring.
in the main event. Women's Championship and Jay Daniels going against Jenny.
Introducing the challenger, representing the Red Faction, from Chattanooga, Tennessee, AJ Daniels!
Ladies and gentlemen, as a reminder, the championship is on the line here tonight.
And in looking at the opposition, I can say that the champion will have quite the hill to climb in this one.
The challenger is all business. She's been training harder than ever for this title opportunity.
And introducing the champion, representing the
seconds away from kicking off one of the most exciting matches in all of WWE, the ladder match.
And tonight, the championship hangs high above the ring as these superstars will likely use every resource available to them to ensure they're the first one up that ladder.
This title defense begins, and it really is lonely at the top, wouldn't you say?
Once you're at the pinnacle, Saxton, you don't care about friends. You have one solitary goal, and that is to defend your title at any cost.
And she's stunned in the corner. And no countouts means she has the whole outside to play with.
She just switched things up in a major way by bringing in that ladder.
Reaching their opponent, look at these. And a series of vicious knee strikes to the body. Doling out as much damage.
Taking flight. Diving body splash.
The champion clearly doing whatever it takes to retain their title here. Roundhouse kick. Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off. Challenger's a little worse for wear now. Carefully placed stomp to the arm. To the outside.
This could get wild.
If you're looking to cause quick, sharp damage, you can't go wrong with the kendo stick.
Dominating shoulder tackle.
So from your vantage point, what should the strategy be here?
Don't go for the home run shot just yet. It's still early in this match, so keep it conservative. Set ladders up to be used later, but for now, the best offense is a good defense.
The champ just striking at will. Merciless display towards the challenger.
Shoulder right to the midsection.
This is just establishing dominance.
Oh, what a stop right to the chest. Are you kidding me?
Oh, yeah, she is really showing her confidence.
The champion is willing to take every risk tonight.
Oh, gosh, what a shot to the face.
Signals the end is near,
but the final prize is still dangling above the ring. Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Kick to the gut.
Blocked the effort and cut them off with a shot to the gut. Slam! With no countouts, there's nothing keeping her inside the ring.
Looks like she's opting to go with the old classic, a steel chair.
Oh my God, a steel chair!
Each competitor wants to prove that they are the toughest woman walking God's green earth. Cannot believe the punishment these superstars are inflicting on one another.
Some hard offense landing on the champ. Ladder matches are all about high risk for high reward, but right now the pain might not be feeling worth the cost.
She's looking highly motivated, getting hyped up. Kick to the gut. Hooked up.
He's gonna try it again. Full extension on the split leg drop.
And she just carved a path for herself.
Laying out the competition before attempting the ascent. She set it up right in the middle of the ring.
Right under the prize. Perfect.
Go to the top here, guys.
Looking to finish it.
Got a hold of it. Yeah, let's see how long that lasts.
Hey, when you have the opening, why not go for it?
That's what's up, though. She won herself a championship. I just wanted to stream just for a little bit, just because I saw our Tribal Chief, but that's over. And now WWE Rivals is on, bro, and Triple H. Well, we all probably seen that like mad times. Could I see the mad times already? I'll be on tomorrow, Monday Night Raw, Rock and Roman, supposed to be there. Let's get it. It's gonna be big, so tune in with me. We gonna be lit. Okay, tomorrow, Monday Night Raw, tune in. I'll be on. Maybe even a little bit before, so let me know. I'm ready. I'm off. And it's Monday. Tribal Chief, Rock, Cody Rhodes, Seth Rollins. What's going to happen? I appreciate everybody, though, that views, likes, thank you for taking a peek, all appreciate it. I'll holler at y'all tomorrow. Later. Oh.